We are freaking doing the thing. This is gonna hit the battlefield. All of our libraries.
Yes.
Six cards left. And everything's face down. You don't know what's there. Everything is face down in exile. You have no clue what is going on. Hey, what's up, everyone? My name is Jeff, and today we are having fun with, I think, the most fun card in the new set, and I think in all of Standard Magic right now. This is such a fun and kind of silly, ridiculous card. Six black mana for a 6/6 flying demon, so actually pretty good stats. When it enters, if it was cast, very important, each player exiles all but the bottom six cards of their library face down. So you don't know what is in your library. You don't know what's been gone. You're completely blind drawing into those last six cards. And at the beginning of your upkeep, you draw a card. And so, first off, that means that we're going to be drawing more cards than them. And so just on its face, we're playing a 6-mana 6/6 flyer. It's going to hit the battlefield, and we are going to be drawing two cards each turn while they're drawing one. If this dies, we lose the game is kind of how that ends up working out. If we end up drawing too many, but if we have a way to mill them out, then we of course win. And that's what our deck is built around, is being able to actually mill them out. The hard part is that when you're playing mono black, it's really hard to mill, and we can definitely like splash in blue, which we have done here to be able to do this. However, I think that there is kind of a fun one turn combo kill with this that I was really excited for, to try to go completely mono black with this. I ended up splashing in Jace, blue for Jace, because the Overlord also digs for planeswalkers. And since I didn't have a lot of creatures in here to be searching for, I figured just like being able to find another piece would be pretty good. And then also Restless Reef can also hit in and cause them to mill four cards. Anyway, so there's two little splashes just to make sure that we actually can make the combo happen and actually win the game here, and make it not as fragile of them just removing Scavenger's Talent, because Scavenger's Talent says it's one mana. Whenever one or more creatures you control die, create a food token. That's important, but we don't have a ton of creatures. The second level here is the important part. Whenever you sacrifice a permanent, target player mills two cards. And if we have level three up and activated, then at the beginning of, I believe, every end step, you may sacrifice three other non-land permanents. If you do, return a creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield with a finality counter on it. So we play out Doomsday Excruciator from our hand, and then we're able to sacrifice three permanents at the end step. So they have all their cards milled except for six. End step comes around, we sacrifice six permanents, they mill six more cards, we win the game. So there is kind of a pretty cheap or pretty like a straightforward two card combo with this that works out pretty well. We also can, you know, Jace on the next turn or whatever. But there is also a certain side of, if we bring this back from the graveyard, it doesn't mill all the cards, and it's just a 6/6 flyer that can also help us draw an extra card on our upkeep without having to pay extra life or anything. So it's just decent. We can just, if it is in the graveyard, mill to or sacrifice permanents to bring it to the battlefield and have a win con there as well. Same thing with the Overlord. We have a couple creatures that are pretty big that we can play early on, like this one, to be able to mill four cards, return planeswalkers or creatures, non-avatar creatures, to our hand, which is where we can get like a Shieldred if we want to have it hit, or make sure that we actually have the Doomsday Excruciator in our hand, and then we go through the process of milling. I really wanted to push heavy towards the Scavenger Talent option, and so I'm trying to play this as like a two-turn combo rather than just like, and we milled them, and then we're gonna find some random way to mill six cards. I think that trying to stay in mono black makes it fun, and there's not that many cards that do it as well as this does. And so we have kind of a bargain and food token removal package here with this as well. So we have Candy Grapple, which has this bargain, which will sacrifice a token, or sacrifice artifact, enchantment, whatever, so then we can mill with Scavenger's Talent here. And also I think it's just decent removal actually, if you are actually playing enough enchantments and everything, which, you know, Overlord counts as an enchantment that'll be on the battlefield that you can sacrifice if you need to. Food token with Gumdrop Poisoner, and then also Witch's Vanity, which will be an enchantment that could be sacrificed, and also create food token, everything. So I'm excited for this, guys. I think that this will be super fun. This sounds, I just want this to happen. Winning after the fact does matter, but not nearly as much as just simply actually being able to play Doomsday Excruciator. And so let's go ahead and take this into the gameplay and wish me luck. Here we go. All right, up against Beepo, and this is good. We'll keep this. Do I play the Tapland or do I go for Candy Trail right away? I guess I need to see what I actually want to look for. So I'll just play the Tapland first. We have good removal for turn two and three for an aggro deck. More tap lands. Still fine, and I definitely think we need to hold up the Candy Grapple. Ooh, really? Nothing. Is this a tokens deck then? Okay. In that case, this becomes a little bit different, doesn't it? Candy Trail. I also feel like this is a matchup where it's slow enough that we actually can get the combo off. Treasure Map. Quite like that. Do I want it before the land? What's my next turn? And yeah, actually, that's... If they do nothing, then that's the play. And actually, I think that I draw it right away. I'm fine with a little bit slower lands. Yeah, so let's play it out past the turn. We'll draw that. Yep, Caretaker's Talent, draw. So we just have to combo before they go crazy. And we're not dealing with really anything of theirs at the moment. Just Treasure Map. We're going to start scrying. Pass turn. Do I want to scry on my upkeep as well? I'll hold the mark just in case. It might be Overlord here, though. To actually dig for the combo piece. Oh, I forgot they got new pieces to this combo. Land, that gets us to six lands, so yes, we'll keep. And now I don't need to stop on, so we'll draw. And we'll go Overlord. Just trying to find the combo. That's all that matters here. And we have the Excruciator.
All right, we'll see if that works.
If this had Trample, I feel like we'd be in a much better space. Also, we won't be able to attack with this once we actually mill their deck. And so, it'll be fun. We definitely need to find a way to actually like mill them. Oh wait, we have the Restless Sleeves. The whole reason I put them in the deck. We got it, guys. We're good. They're definitely not going to have removal for any of these kinds of crazy things. See, they're using it on the wrong card. They don't even know what's going on. Silly, silly Beepo. Oh, man. All right. Let's go with this. All right. Dude, these cards are cool. I definitely think this is the best one, in my opinion, of the Overlords. There it is, the Overlords. All right, we're doing the thing. We are freaking doing the thing. This is going to hit the battlefield. All of our libraries.
Yes.
Six cards left. And everything's face down. You don't know what's there. Everything is face down in exile. You have no clue what is going on. They get lost. Okay, so we can't draw. That's fine. We have to find a way to mill, which we have with the Restless Leaves. They keep using the kill spells on the wrong stuff. Do they have more, though? I don't know, and I'm kind of terrified. Down to seven. That's bad. Okay, so they're down to five. This mills them for four, and we're going to be one off, aren't we? So we have to kill instead. This is at their end step. So we have to... Witch's Vitality. K Candy Grapple and Liliana of the Veil. And then I can hold up Shieldred to kill this.
Something suspicious is going on. And for once, it's not my fault.
All right, we're down to 7. That's really low. Just in case they have like a way to create another one here, I guess we should wait. Pass turn. The best card off the top will be the Scavenger's Talent, I believe. I think we have enough mana to pay for all of the modes and then sacrifice stuff at the end step. What I want them to do here is go for a Caretaker's Talent and pay for it on this. Okay, if they go to attacks, then we kill it. Do we go for the bargain just in case? I can't think of anything that they would have to buff this. Okay. Please spend removal on the Liliana. We're at 5, they're at 3. They're drawing cards with this Caretaker's Talent. If they ever attack with this, it's gonna draw them cards. Oh my gosh, 4 damage to our face. Oh, that's bad. Okay, we get food tokens though, and that's what matters. Okay, oh gosh, dang it, freaking Restless Leaf. I had the win and I just missed it. Oops. Okay. Make them discard. We can still have fun. It's all good. I think we definitely have to draw here though, or gain the life. Map token. I think I like that better than the treasure map. Do I do it in response when they can have more mana up and available? Pass the turn. Not right now, but not right now. I'm so sorry. Sorry. All right, let's see. Can they pull it together somehow? If they can like bounce that, well, there's nothing that they have that does that, do they? Oh wait, there's a, I think I saw a version with like scroll shift or something like along those lines. If they go for it though, we crack the food. They're down to 2 cards and I have the Restless Leaf. I don't know why I didn't think about Restless Leaf on the second turn after we stayed alive. Exile our graveyard, they can gain life, okay. Well, yeah, what's this gonna do for you? Down to 2 cards. We have 4. They got rid of the thing that would help us draw when they had blockers. This is so fun. Like this is the part of Magic I love, is this kind of like, all right, it is down to the wire. Now what do you do? And I feel like this card in this deck makes that happen. Which, oh, that's so fun. The scary part here is that they could have Lightning Strike or Lightning Helix, and they do it in response to us cracking the food. So we're holding it up as long as possible until we either have another food or, you know, something else. We can, I'm going to hold actually up on the upkeep here. They're Scryed 2 with the last 2 cards. So they know what they have, which is funny. Oh man, they don't draw here. Bummer. They create a token, they draw a card. What are you doing? All right. We know what one of our cards is. Okay, and my turn. They already did this, so we're gonna go ahead and sack the food. It doesn't matter. We're gonna attack with Restless Leaf now that they've gone there. We could have gone with the that doesn't matter. Restless Reef goes in and attacks and mill them. There we go. All right, I missed the turn of being able to Restless Reef when they had less, but still worked out.
Dude.
That is fun. Aw. That is so fun. We're doing that again. Beautiful starting hand. Absolutely love this. That's fantastic. I've been spawning red. Suddenly becomes less good. Talent is good as well. Let's go for this though, Scry. We need removal. A second Liliana. Is that good enough removal? It's not lands. Yeah. I think it's both to the bottom, as weird as that is. The deck has been having some issues finding the lands. I'm at 25 lands, which I have found odd number of lands is for some reason really weird. Destroy my way to gain life. Ooh, that's good removal though. Do I wait for them to have a way to buff it? Now that they have two toughness on some of the stuff they do, and they missed the land drop, so I think we go on all in here. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? They miss land. That's what matters. Liliana? Yes. Oh, is this any target?
When I
win. Ooh, okay. I totally forgot that it's any target, so they could actually just kill the Liliana. But still. One land. Huzzah. All right, we have some removal. We have the combo. That, to me, seems like a keep. Do I get this out right away? I want every extra turn to be spent spending the mana on this. And so, yes. I think instead of playing Restless Reef there, we go for the Scavenger's Talent. Having multiple of these is a little interesting. Ooh, the Bronco. He dead. I really like these lakes, the Gloom Lake Verge. These are better than I was thinking, but it's only for specific decks that they'll really work with, I feel like. Okay, takes away one of the pieces. If this is a discard deck, that's not fun. And it'd also be fun to, you know, like draw things that mattered at some point. But we're getting to our combo. And so honestly, actually, if they can't play fast enough, we do just kind of take over. If we can even find like removal for the bat and then just play these six lands, play the excruciator and combo off here. That's the game. And then we have the rest of three. This deck really doesn't need anything but those two cards. I guess we need more permanents to actually sacrifice. And they have the other one, nice. We got nothing else going for us, but we're gonna kill those bats and get them back. Don't you worry. That's not how we do it. I think this is an instance I do mill myself. Because I can play out the candy trail. Chase is over there. We can play this out and draw. I could also sacrifice permanence. There's poisoner to be able to do something here. Don't need lands anymore. Do I play this or do I draw and grab that? I think that we're going to be drawing. Let's pass turn, though. We can do all of that on their turn. Okay, draw. We're gonna mill. Oh man, that's the poisoner. Oopsies, I messed up. All good. Unpunished. Man, I am not playing the greatest.
No more distractions.
Doesn't matter.
Let's make this quick.
Okay, get back.
I've always hated
excruciating. Play another talent. And the fun thing here is, I guarantee you, if this excruciator actually hits, they're gonna wanna kill it. And they shouldn't, because that'll give me 2 food tokens to then mill with the scavenger's talent. So, this next turn, it all comes down to this. Oh my goodness, this is so fun. Go kill the Liliana, that's fine. It is a permanent, which helps with all of the stuff. At least getting this back from the graveyard is still like a decent thing if we wanted to do it. Shrumpeting Carnosaur. All right, how combo-y do they get here? Cut down, you can have it. We have the Restless Reef as well. So we're not in danger of losing. Yet they are. Okay. The libraries are exiled. It is down to 5 cards for you. I will draw 2 on my turn. And I can combo off here and win. They have to remove enough permanents that I can't sacrifice these and mill the 6. Because I believe is it other permanents, or is it at the beginning of your end step, you may sacrifice 3 other non-land permanents. Okay, that's important. I do have the bat to play. So we take it, no blocks. The goal is not... Oh wait, I guess I should have killed the bat. Oops, whatever. I was just focusing on the trumpet card. Sorry, man, I'm so like out of practice with this game somehow. All right, which is vitality, vanity is good. All right, so play this. Activate this. I don't have to have a thing to target, do I? Vanity. Kill the bat. And I'm gonna play the decounter bat. I want them to cut this down to give me more food tokens. Please have at it. You can do it. I believe in you. Go for it. Give me all the food tokens so that at the end, we now, doesn't matter. No attacks, because we're going to sacrifice 1, 2, and 3. And we can choose Poisoner. And we're going to mill. Doesn't matter. You. You. And you. It worked like exactly as I planned it out. Oh my goodness. And draw. And that's the game. Yes! Oh, that's beautiful. And we had the Restless Reef there as well to, you know, we could have attacked in with it, got them down low enough and protected ourselves enough that we would have been fine. And so, man, that's cool. It does come down to like this really scary moment after you mill yourself, though. And it's like, oh, what could happen? That's so fun. I love it. All right, here we go. Decent hand. I like it. A bunch of 2-drop early game things to do. Love it. Land on top and our combo piece, which means we're not going for Overlord next turn. I guess I could, actually. Should I keep both on top? I can go Overlord next turn, bring it to hand, like guarantee that I'm drawing a card with it, basically the card that I want. But then they do that. Do I have the time to do this? I mean, if it's ever gonna come into play for the game, I gotta do it earlier on. The bat was probably the better play, but we're doing this. We're gonna play the combo. And red is gonna do what red things do, and we did not draw the hand for red. But we could. That was 2 removal pieces that we got rid of there. So, in hindsight, we definitely should have done the not bulwark thing. But that's hindsight. Oh, that's gonna be bad. All right. We don't let them have two monstrous rages, right? That seems silly. This is worse, but they still just can't let them have the monstrous rage. I think letting them have too many pump spells is the worst thing. These guys just being one drops to like the pump is what is scary. Do I block though? Force them to use it here? No. No, we just didn't gain life. They don't go for the pump spell. We don't have any mana up. What are they doing? Bring up more creatures? Why didn't you Monstrous Rage? Okay, here we absolutely go for draw. Because we have to find removal over the bat. The bat's a great thing that we can do. There we go. There we go. Now we can target whatever's necessary. All right. We have the Restless Reef. We have the Excruciator. All we have to do is survive now. I think giving him the Monstrous Rage is worse than anything else, so we're just going to be attacking in. We want to hopefully candy grapple. Let's see here. Letting him draw into more pump spells is the worst thing. I think I candy grapple this before they even use it, despite it's going to be like way more damage. I think we have to hope that they brick again with either a creature that isn't really important here. And just kind of hope that we can survive these next two turns, basically. The bat helps for the next turn, and we're just and top decking removal. This is what we need. Of course. Of course. That is not the worst draw, I don't think, though. Surprising at this point. Like Slickshot should it's like the second worst draw. I think the buff spell that like gives him lots of extra damage is what would be worse. All right, just, okay, it is a 3-3. Shouldred is interesting. The issue here is that they can sacrifice a Heartfire hero and kill the bat. Where if I play two bats, this has trample, we take three. I could also just block the show off, and that gets us to Excruciator, which then we might get a turn with Restless Reef. I think I have to be able to block. I was doing some calculations there a little bit, and I think I forgot about adding into... Whoa, they attack our face. Holy crap, that's a big deal. Sure. I mean, we still have a very high chance of being dead here. But if they're only attacking with one, that's a very good sign. Okay. We have a big flyer now, and you now have no deck. Or basically no deck. We have a bunch of blockers. I don't think we actually want to attack with anything but the life linker. Okay, there we go. Get us back up to 8 life. Restless Reef on the next turn. Do not attack with the bulwark. We'll reveal ourselves. Okay, 5. We mill them for 4. They scoop. Dude, I genuinely didn't think, especially with the hand that we had, that we could beat mono red here. And I mean, I feel like they played it a little bit poorly there, but we also made some pretty good decisions that panned out. Awesome. All right, guys, that played out way better than I was thinking. I did end up having 3 games I don't think I'm going to show with this one. It was the very first 3 games. I had a ton of user error with the deck that was just poor piloting, I feel like, on my part. And I ran up against a deck where I, or a game where I between milling myself with Overlord and finding lands, I only had, I think, 7 or 8 lands in the top 30 cards. And I have 20, I had 20, and each of the other games too, I also was running into land issues. And so I had 25 lands to start off with. I switched over to 26, just adding the one extra card here with this. And honestly, that's when everything functioned well. And so I'm going to put it in the deck list as like that, with just like one extra card, one extra land, because I didn't want to cut anything out. It like I didn't want to like cut out Shouldered or the Treasure Map, because they were in there for the reasons that I wanted them there. Treasure Map, I think now I would cut in favor of a second Candy Trail. And so that's what I would change there. I would go for the Candy Trail was definitely good. Like I think needing to draw cards when we needed to, scrying, have a permanent on the battlefield, and gaining the life was like literally everything that it needed to be. And so Candy Trail with Gumdrop Poisoner works well. I could see there being an argument for like getting another like one drop or two drop creature, so that you can have creatures that die to create the food tokens to help out with all of this kind of food combo. That being said, I don't think it's as important as just like just surviving long enough to get to the Doomsday Excruciator. And so I feel like the combo is more around this rather than making sure that we have the early game creatures. There is the there is the rat here. The Gnawing Vermin is the other one that I was thinking about including into this. Sacrificing it also allows you to target player mills 2 cards. But the issue is that the only way that we have to sacrifice this purposefully is with the Scavenger's Talent. We could kill it of our own, like one of like with our own spells or something like that. But even Bargain doesn't let you sacrifice the creature for this. And having it mill in the early game really isn't that important. It does help if we find the Bulwark that this is in the graveyard. We can find it. So like it helps a little bit. Anyway, so I think like 2 of these could come into play if you guys want to build around and brew your own version. But honestly, I think this worked quite well. I think I was impressed with how well I was able to splash into blue and have plenty of blue in this. And I'm really not going that aggressively like into splashing blue. You know, like I think you could go even more aggressively. And I think Gloomlake Verge really adds to being able to play like a really heavy black deck, but still have, you know, still have the blue mana that you need, and this still lets us play a 6 mana, you know, 6 black spells. And so I think that you could even add in a few, like 4, I would say you could add in like 4 more blue lands, maybe even 6, maybe even more, honestly. I there's actually a lot right now. And then you could just play blue mill cards along with this, and maybe some control and maybe counter spells and all that stuff, and still like guarantee that you're going to be hitting the Excruciator. So like honestly, I think that coming into a control version of this could be pretty good, but I think it's a legitimately good strategy. I think get to 6 mana, it's an ETB trigger that you can't really stop, and once it's happened you got 6 cards. It doesn't affect board state that much, but it is a 6/6 flyer that they're gonna have to deal with. So if they, you know, have a board presence, this blocks a lot of stuff. And so then it's just a matter of we have to find a way to mill them. You know, I think the 4 cards and survive a couple turns is it. So, you know, oh my goodness, so much fun. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much, and bye-bye.